Hi, I'm Mallory Tevini, and I'm a manufacturing engineer here at Haas Automation. In this video, I'm excited to show you some ideas on how you can customize the Haas robot packages to the needs of your shop. You may be wondering a few things, like what types of stock can you pick up, how can you lay material out, and what are your options for picking the parts up or dropping them off? To address these points, I programmed some examples that fit into three categories. One, gripper variations, two, template options, and three, pickup and drop-off ideas. Let's start with what types of stock you can pick up with the robot. The short answer is, if it can sit secure in your vise or chuck, you can probably pick it up. So let's talk about gripper variation. A single gripper comes standard with multiple movable finger attachments, but you can also purchase a dual gripper, which is helpful to reduce cycle times by loading a raw part directly after unloading a completed piece. Keep in mind that with both styles of grippers, you can grip on either the inside or the outside of your part. Plus, we also include alternate fingers that can be adapted for bar stock. And if you wanted to get a bit more creative, you can use shorter or longer fingers on an aftermarket adaptable three-jaw chuck to achieve a self-centering motion, as I've done here. The possibilities are endless with the amount of aftermarket pneumatic grippers available. There are even pneumatically actuated magnetic grippers that grip on flat and cylindrical faces. Transitioning to laying out your material, it's a good idea to consider whether you need more precision or more flexibility. For example, if you are repeatedly machining large batches or working with unique parts, I'd recommend either a laser cut or custom template. If you're working with parts that cannot stack but need to run a large batch, you may want to consider a drawer card option. On the other hand, a pegboard is a great option to use the same template style for a range of jobs, as you can rearrange posts to fit different shapes, sizes, and orientations. You can even use Legos as an inexpensive, adjustable alternative that still offers consistency. Lastly, let's discuss some of the possibilities on part pickup and drop-off. When setting your template into control, you have two options for part pickup: single point or table grid. Single point is a great option for when you're picking up the part in the same place each time, such as in conveyor loading or gravity loading. Table grid is much more common where you lay your stock out in rows and columns on a flat grid. For drop-off, you have three options: single table, dual table, or single point. Single table is great for when you'd like to place the finished parts back on the same table that you picked them up from. Dual table will place completed parts on a separate table in the same row and column spacing. The third option, single point, is simple to program but has endless opportunities to explore. Single point will drop the finished parts in the same place each time after the program ends. This could be as simple as dropping all the parts into a bucket or bin for easy removal of the batch. But you could also use this option together with further automation or another mechanical system to start the post-processing on parts as the program is still running. Here, you see the parts being placed on a conveyor belt to transport them outside of the cage so that they can be safely reached or removed while the safety cage remains shut. If more automation isn't desirable, a simple PVC pipe ramp can be constructed to offer a similar advantage. No matter your shop's preferences, I hope this video gave you some insight on the wide range of flexibility that the Haas robot packages can provide. Thanks for watching.